That's like when you got an electric screwdriver after screwdriving and, you know, and getting muscles in your arm your whole life, and then you discover the electric screwdriver and you're like, hey, where was this thing my whole life? That's what the Dynamount is. It's the electric screwdriver in my toolkit. Hey, I'm Joe Barisi. I'm here at my studio in Pasadena. I do spend all my non-working days in my own studio when possible and experiment with, you know, testing microphones and testing gear and listening to 18 direct boxes and all the crazy stuff that nobody in their right mind would ever do. The idea of putting a microphone up and being able to infinitely move it as you're playing and hear how it reacts and then how it fits into a track is an invaluable resource. It's life-changing, actually, especially if you're doing stuff by yourself.
Dynamount and Postmates have made producing at home easy. My name is Beau Burchell. I'm a producer, mixer, engineer in Southern California. I'm also the guitarist and founding member of the band Saveson. As soon as I got the Dynamount, it was just like, I don't know how I ever lived without this before. Yeah, I'm kind of a freak. Can't ever hit record because is this actually the best position on the cabinet with this microphone? You know what I mean? It's just that constant searching for the best. I think part of the reason why I spend so much time getting the tones is because I'm not only the person who's recording it, I'm the person that's producing it, and I'm gonna have to deal with those sounds when it comes time to mix. For me, I have to make sure everything is really dialed.
So the whole Gen 2 Dynamount product line comes in three core variants. We have the X2R, X2R Micro, which has a smaller footprint, and then we also have the V2R, which is the single axis with rotation.
So one of the things I really like about the new X2R is the motors are so much quieter, they're so much smoother, and then especially when you're sweeping now, there's absolutely no noise from the motors happening. And then when you're making your stops or adjustments, you actually get 10 times more level of detail. So like the increments are 10 times smaller.
You can actually now feel as though you're holding that microphone in front of that speaker.
On a guitar, where every millimeter or microscopic movement is a huge difference in sound, I think it's re-educating people what moving a microphone actually is what you're supposed to do as an engineer. That's the definition of engineering.
Usually you're kind of stuck in your standard ways of putting a microphone that we all see, you know, and it looks right to you, but it doesn't necessarily sound the best. I'd say for me, the biggest thing is it takes the visual side out. And then you listen to it and you're like, I don't know, the weird mic position just sounds better. And I never would have put it there had I not like used my ears and listened.
In the end, there are no rules. And that's what it really comes down to.
Dynamount lets you be creative because most of the time you're riding that line of efficiency versus creative. If you have a robot that can help you with that and you can listen, I mean, it's like just a shortcut.
Whatever your workflow is, if you like to use your phone or an iPad or your computer and you just have your DAW and that's it, we want to be able to give you a way to control Dynamount and give you options. So now you have USB, Wi-Fi, and Ethernet, so three distinct control methods. The software that controls the X2R is brand new. It's vastly more sophisticated than the software that was controlling the X1R. And it has quite a few features that are not found in the first gen app or with the first gen products. You can control the speed of the unit, the acceleration of the unit. You can set range limits. One exciting feature of the X2R that I personally love is phone tilt joystick, which we like to call Jedi mode. You can use the accelerometers that are built into your phone to steer the Dynamount.
Basically, if you tilt it one way, it'll move one way, and if you tilt it another way, another way, so that seems pretty cool.
I just envision sitting in the sweet spot, eyes closed, monitors right in front of me, and I can pretend like the mic's in my hand almost. It really, like, it's simple, but like one of the most powerful features we offer are the position presets. The ability to save physical mic placements as presets that you can just recall at the push of a button.
Or maybe in a solo you need a super articulate part, so I'll have a preset set for articulation and I'll go to that articulate part.
You save as many of those as you want. You just find spots you like, you mark it in the app as a preset, and then it's saved.
Not that I'm always gonna say that's the preset, we have to use it because you're using your ears, but the fact that I can dial in, you know, minuscule amounts, especially now with this capsule lock.
It's not just encouraging experimentation, like it actually makes it like fun to experiment with different mic placements.
I am actually a non-tech savvy person, but when there are things to me that can make my job easier, I'm totally into it. Once you plug it in, the instructions are really easy. The layout on the phone is great. The fact that I can do it on a computer and not have to be an old man and try to put my goggles on and look on a phone is way better too. And then when you see the controller that I have in there, that'll blow your mind as well.
I prefer using the USB joystick option. Now you don't have to switch between your Dynamount app window and your DAW window. You can just have your DAW window open and your Dynamount app can be in the background, so not taking up screen real estate. I can't see the app and I can't see the speaker, so it's just whatever it lands on is the best tone.
You're getting a product that's more sophisticated, more versatile, more precise, quieter, and I mean, even things like usable for more applications.
The Dynamount has really enabled people to make IRs in a timely manner. You know, there's a pretty big demand for impulse responses now. Really just the recallability of it, being able to put the mic back in the same spot and recall that position and then shoot it, go again, and work your way down through all the different microphones that you're using, swapping out speakers, taking captures of those. With the Dynamount, it makes it so much easier. Another thing I'm super excited about is being able to custom order specific sizes to your cabinet. So say if I wanted to have a rail that went all the way across the entire length of both speakers, I could do that if I wanted to.
On top of the standard variants, we have our whole custom shop. So whether you want single axis or dual axis, we can do that for you to your exact specs. And we have the addition of a Z-axis accessory. So now not only are you limited to dual axis XY, you can actually go up and down as well.
I think I would use the larger ones on overheads and stuff like that. What I like about this Dynamount is it does the same thing, plus it's a smaller profile.
We have the X2R Micro, which has a smaller footprint and includes power over Ethernet.
Now you can do Ethernet up to like 100 feet of power. So that's awesome if you have like a little doghouse or an ISO box.
Companies like Box of Doom are even starting to make their boxes with Ethernet ports on them.
To me, when the idea sparks, it's basically being ready at all times.
You know, whereas usually if you're only worried about efficiency, you're usually cutting out creativity, right? I mean, it's kind of like that kind of like meme pie you would see. It's like you can have a good, fast, or cheap, you know what I mean? But like, pick two. But I feel like that's kind of how it is in the studio world too. You're either set up, no, I have my 57 on my cab with the 421 and that's my cab. Don't touch it, it stays there, you know? And you usually don't experiment with that because you don't want to mess it up.
Fading up a guitar sound by having the mic start off axis far away and then kind of rolling it in instead of having to do it with EQ was way cooler. I mean, back in my day, I would be out here moving it as it was going down, but now I could do it automatically from the control room.
You have your presets and you can say, yeah, I'm gonna try something else. And if I don't like it, I'm gonna go right back to where it is. And I know that it's gonna be exactly perfect to where it is. And I think there's comfort in that. You're not living your best life if you don't have one.